श्रुतिस्मृतिपुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्रभाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेदविभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यो ब्रह्माण विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तगुम्हदेयमात्मविद्युत्प्रकाशं मुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। श्री चिद्गणगणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपं अधिष्ठानं बुद्ध्यबोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्वं पारं सर्ववेदान्तवेद्यं प्रत्यक्परं महः तदेवाहन्नमत्वन्यत् इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। सॉरी। सो एनी कंटिन्यूइंग विद दी वैराग्य प्रकरण। सो भर्चु दि अमात्य गॉट वैराग्य दैट इज बीइंग मेंशनड हियर। And for a sadhaka, it is the second step driven by viveka. But vairagya is a very important step. Therefore, although it seems very distasteful, you know, the gory details have been mentioned. And if you look into it, why is it given in this manner? The audience here for this chapter, fifth chapter, is Madhyama Adhama Adhikari. The earlier Adhikari in the fourth chapter was Tattva Drishti, who was a Uttama Adhikari. Uttama Adhikari already has Viveka Vairagya, Shamadhi Shatka Sampatti, and Mumukshutvam. So the direct teaching was given to that sadhaka. He didn't have these kind of questions, whether moksha is possible, not possible. So the question that Adrishti asked in this chapter shows that the Shraddha is lacking. Because he said, how can Shruti and Guru lead to Moksha? So that Samshaya shows that the Shraddha is lacking. And Shraddha is an indicator. He is one of the indicators, of course, to Chitta Shuddhi. So Chitta Shuddhi not being there, Shraddha will be lacking. There will be more and more questions. Questions are entertained. Questions are also answered. Avagati Paryantam Jnanam. So Jnana is given till the Sadhaka gets it. However, the Sadhaka has to be readied for it. So this is the reason there is a screen has started flickering. Just give me a moment. So this is the reason Vivekadi Sadhana Chatushte Sampatti is being described in a different manner. Because the earlier introductory chapters, three chapters which talked about it, haven't worked enough. Because it is not just theory. Jnana is theory which itself is practice, which is bereft of practice. You do not need practice for Jnana. In Jnana Kanda. In Karma Kanda, for Chitta Shuddhi to be there, the Jnana of the Karma Upasana is needed and one has to do the Karma and Upasana. Now just knowing that, Viveka Vairagya is important, I know the discrimination. The discrimination is not to be in the class, it is to be imbibed in one's own life. That is why this is being talked about, Vairagya. And I had mentioned earlier also, to buffer it again, this is not about a woman. So those who are, you know, think that this is against anti-women, see, this is all mlecha thinking. This is borrowed from outside and they have taught us that your culture is bad because they wanted to harm our culture. So with that background, you have to understand all this modern setup of, you know, the Indian woman is not free. Those who think that the Indian woman is not free should look at our history, the right history. should study that. And I would encourage people who, you know, think that they are Uttama Adhikaris to study. This I generally don't say, but there is a lot of background to this. So please study Tripura Rahasya. I'll not mention this again. And please don't ask me questions. If you already know about it, well and good. If you don't, then study Tripura Rahasya, where the teacher is the woman. So here I have mentioned again, when the ninda of a stri is done here, this is for a sadhaka. It is not a general statement. Similarly, if the woman is a sadhaka, the ninda of a man is done. Should be done. This I have said earlier also. If you are still confused, then look at the following section also in that manner. So thereby, here what was said is yoginah siddhascha bindu samrakshana balenaiva khechari mudrabhyasadina animadi siddhi siddhim urdhvaretastvam shreshtyam cha abhajanta. And I'll also say something. When we look at the shastra is tuned towards moksha. It has nothing to do with gender. It is tuned towards moksha of the jiva in whichever body the jiva is. If it happens to be a man's body, then the antakarana is configured in a particular manner. Everyone here is matured enough to know that the woman's antakarana and the man's antakarana is different. It may be using the same component, but the configuration is different. A man does not understand a woman's mind. Woman does not understand a man's mind. Most of you are better qualified than me, a brahmachari, to know each other's mind across the gender. So we know that the mind works differently in a man's body and in a woman's body. Therefore, the sadhanas for chitta shuddhi are different. Even the yogasanas which are mentioned in the yoga shastra, not everyone can do it. It is not about capability. It is about how the kundalini works in a man or a woman. It is different. For example, a particular asana mentioned for a man should not be done by a woman. There are some, because the mudras are different. Specifically, I mentioned it because of khechari. Khechari mudra may be practiced by both, but the Mooladhara, those who know some yoga shastra, I am giving this background because this section is going to be further distasteful. The way it was distasteful earlier, if you thought it was not, why are we spending time here? Most of the people would skip this section. I want to go through this section, especially because in Arsha Vidya Gurukula Sampradaya itself, Vasana Kshaya is not given importance. In fact, Pujya Swamiji did not want people to focus on Vasana Kshaya. He would say, you are okay the way you are. That was his compassion. His name was Dayananda. It was his Daya. Don't take it literally. Please understand where Pujya Swamiji was coming from. He says, you are okay with jnana, but we have to know whether we can stay in jnana. Nishtha is important. Having jnana is easier. Swami Paramarthan says jnana is nothing. Nothing in the sense, it is very easy in comparison to the manana and nitidhyasana. Nishtha is the most difficult aspect. So in our acharana, do we have this? This is what we need to know, because most of us are gate crashers. Unfortunately, but it's a fact. We have to be true to our own pursuit. Is my karma in line with my understanding of aikya? One may say, oh, karma can be anything. That is for a jnani, because he has a karma bhasa. We don't have karma bhasa. Each and every thinking of ours is backing the karma. And if it is, then we need as much sadhana. If it has not been done pre-jnana, it has to be done post-jnana, called as nididhyasana. That is why yoga shastra, the yogic process, cannot be set aside. Anyway, this is an aside to say that some of the things are common across man and woman. Some are not. Most of the things are not, because of the mind being different, the body being different. Therefore, the yogasana can also be said specifically for a man. I don't want to go into more details. but you can look up Siddhasana if you want. Siddhasana, how it is practiced, you'll know. Please do not ask me questions on this in class or outside class. I'm not going to talk about this because this is not talked about generally. It is not encouraged. It is kept a secret and it should be kept a secret. But I'm saying this only because these questions come up with Vairagya, why this is talked about, why from a man's perspective, why a woman is insulted. So grow up beyond the gender. Go beyond the gender. The gender identification shows that one does not have jnana. It is jnana bhasa. As soon as you start defending the gender, you have owned it up. You have become a part of ajnana. The ajnana influence is so strong, you are unable to step out. The jnana has not worked, so sadhana is needed. Nothing wrong in it. We all of us have to focus on the aspect which is missing. We have to hold on to the jnana. Jnana rakshana has to be done. Till it works completely. Till ajnana nasha is done. Virodharte nanj. Therefore, it has to take away the ajnana completely. Acharana has to be in line. Anyway, with so much of background, I just mentioned something about Khechari because it has gone by. Before we go further to this, since it's coming up, let me finish this section. As it is distasteful. So let's finish this and then we look at Khechari. So Bindukshaya, Bindu is the last dhatu which is created in the body and it has to be preserved. And the yogis move it upwards instead of outwards and downwards. So the apana, prana, one of the pranas, apana, moves the indriyas outward. With that, each and every dhatu is focused outwards. Just to keep it simple. And therefore, it is focused outward and downward. It has to move, the entire process is to, the journey is to move inward and upwards. Thereby, this Khechari mudra helps for that reason. And this is not easy, but those who want to practice, this is a risky thing. Do not practice if you do not know, if you have not been initiated especially. But if one wants to try out what it does, one can fold one's tongue upwards and not much, just fold it upwards, roll it upwards and close your mouth. Just keep it that way as much as you can. The rest can follow, but just fold the tongue upwards because the tongue causes havoc. It is for taste also and for as an output also, it blabbers. So the tongue is a difficult indriya. As an indriya golaka really, but it works as a karmendriya as well as jnanendriya. Anyway, it has to be folded, and in Khechari what happens is that the tongue is completely pulled inside. It does not remain inside the mouth at all. It goes upwards. And there are people in Hatha Yoga who cut their tongue. Beneath the tongue, there is a tissue which holds it with the lower layer of the mouth. And they cut it. This is actually supposed to be in Hatha Yoga also. It should be cut by the Guru with a particular leaf. But Hatha Yoga practitioners today, moderners, especially Westerners, they cut their tongue. I won't say that Indians don't do it, but they do it. But this Hatha Yoga does not work well, especially if not initiated by a guru and guided by a guru. The Khechari initiation is additional. In addition to this, the cutting of the tongue, etc., should be done by the guru, not by anyone, you know, taking a blade or whatever. These people do a lot of things. So this is the risk. So which should not be done. The other marga of Khechari, which is, where the guru initiates and imparts one's own energy to the sadhaka, that is safer. Shakti path, it is safer. Where these mudras and everything is automatic. There is nothing that the sadhaka does specifically. There is no hatha involved there. Sadhaka does not say, this is what I want to do. What happens? Happens in course of time. So anyway, so the tongue is folded back and then over a period of time, it is pushed backwards and then upwards and so on. Anyway, so that's about Khechari. We'll see more in the Tippana what it means. But here, Bindukshaya eva sarva anartha nidanam. The karana for every anartha is Bindukshaya, because a person is interested to stay forever. So now you have to, this is physicalized. Physicalize the philosophy. Physicalizes, it is explained as to why the body is so, why is the mind so? Because each jiva wants anantyam, wants amruta. Through Khechari also one wants amruta. Through Khechari, the amruta is not figurative, it is literal. It is literal, there is amruta flows in Khechari Siddhi. Anyway, that's not our focus. Our focus is Vedanta. In Vedanta, how do you get amrutattvam? Amrutattvam is your real nature, so it has to be understood. But it is not understood. So before understanding and even after understanding, why do we hold on to the same things that we do? Because the amrutattvam, anantyam that we are searching for, although we know it is our nature, it is still not held on to well, not understood well enough to drop other pursuits. Other pursuits continue. And if other pursuits continue, then jnana and other pursuits do not go together. They do not go together, because if the pursuit is knowing that I am free, it's a different story. Then the pursuits will automatically drop off. One won't attach to it. So it is for each one of us to see if it's the pursuits or anything that we do. Why do we do? Is it leading to jnana? Is it protecting my jnana? Or during the indulgence, I am lost as a jiva. So for those people and for ajnanis, what has to be done? Like Adrushti is told the Bharchu Katha, where the Bharchu Katha has jnana, but the author is taking details of the Bharchu Katha and elaborating them, assuming that the Shishya does not have it. This is the reason the Vairagya is being elaborated so much. So physically, how this manifests, this ajnana, physically and mentally, emotionally, how does it manifest? That the jiva is already ananta, but thinks that he is antavan, therefore he wants to become ananta. To become ananta, he knows that I am going to die when the body dies. This is his misunderstanding, his or her misunderstanding. Therefore, wanting to live forever, there is a desire for progeny. Even a person who does not want to marry, there is a desire for progeny unknowingly, because one wants to live forever through the progeny. That is why in Sanskrita, the child is called as Santana. Samyak Tanotiti. So the Tanu, Vistare, that Dhatu shows that there is Vistara, Vistarana, there is a desire to live forever, tending to infinity. And due to that desire, whatever has to take place emotionally, mentally and physically, that will happen, manifest in the body. And this is the manifestation of karma. So one who thinks that by karma, by progeny, by begetting children, I will live forever, this thinking is not known, but this is how it is manifest. And this is the reason the karma aspect is the most difficult to control. Even Gita Acharya Bhagavan Krishna says so. We have seen in examples of Vishwamitra, who is almost there but lost it for a good while. That is why Indra sends Menaka. That's why the karma aspect is fueled, so that the sadhaka loses in his journey. So this is a trap. That is why it is given more important. And for this reason, where the problem and the disease is intense, there the sweet medication doesn't work. You cannot use sweet words saying that everything is fine, you know, look at the other gender, nothing wrong in it. So the medicine has to be bitter, and this is why the bitter medicine is given, so that one is disgusted. The disgust is created because there is an intense attachment towards it. This is why Shastras talk about the other gender, not only woman, the other gender, in a way that it produces vairagya. It is said that Gurudev Shivananda says that a woman has eightfold desire than a man, but she has eightfold control over it. So man having 1/8 of the control of the woman, he is the one who is blamed, who is to be blamed. And he is the one who is taught as to how one has to control oneself. And that is why Vairagya Shastra is more focused towards the man, because he lacks control. And this need not be talked about, everyone knows about this. That is why the woman is talked about as the root of trouble for the man. Since the man does not have any control, exceptions are different. We don't focus on exceptions, they prove the rule. Even I think in Tulsidas, Bhagwan Tulsidas, who wrote Tulsi Ramayana. In some places they say that he was a brahmachari, in other places they say that he was married. He was married, and in one story, to drive home Vairagya, even such saints have been talked about as having no control over Kama. He was so attached towards his wife. One day when he came back home, he saw that he was told that his wife has gone to her parents' house, Maika. He was so attached, overcome by love towards her, that it was a stormy, rainy, cyclonic day, but still he wanted to cross the Yamuna to reach her. The Yamuna was flooded. He took support of a log and swam across the Yamuna, reached her house. She was on the first floor. So he climbed a rope and reached her. And in this process, he did not find out. His wife was shocked. She was not pleased. She was shocked to see that her saintly husband has become like this. Saintly, he wasn't saintly earlier, maybe. He crossed the Yamuna river thinking that he had a log of wood, but he was holding on to a dead body. He did not even realize under the pressure of Kama that he has held on to the dead body. And when he climbed up her window to reach her window, he didn't climb up a rope, but it was an Asgara, it was a serpent. And this is what is the influence of Kama and why Vairagya is needed. And then she does Dhikkara, says you have lost Rama due to Kama. So where there is Rama, there cannot be Kama. And where there is Kama, Rama will not be there. And that is how he became a saint. Not everyone agrees with this, but this is, so keep all this in your background when this Ninda is being done. Okay, so that's half the class. So Bindu Kshayava Sarva Anartha Nidanam. Now, how do you preserve this that is talked about? And thereby Vairagya does Ninda. So Yoshita, a woman. Yoshita Eva Bindu Kshaya Karanam. The opposite gender is the reason for every loss. Yatha Gudakamshino Manavaha Ikshudandam Yantre Nishpidya Tadrasam Grihitva Nissaram Ikshudandam Durekshipanti Tathaiva Ratikangshinyo Mahilaha Kamaturam Purusham Sabhujabhyam Bhrusham Apidya Tadanga Nisratam Viryam Grihitva Kshina Viryam Tam Durataha Parityajanti. So I'll not go into details, as I mentioned earlier. This is understood by everyone who understands enough Sanskrit. Anyway, the example is given of the sugarcane. After the sugarcane is extracted, the sugarcane is useless. This is the case of the Purusha who has no virya. So that is said here. So that is why the Vairagya is important. Sarvottamayam bindum kamaparavasha mudaha kshanamatra sukha lavalipsaya mattanga nasu viniyojya krameena kshina bindavaha katipaihi eva divasaihi lupta dehendriya manovirya durvalaha. So durvala, here there is a vakara bakara error. So abayor abheda, vakara and bakara are interchangeable in Sanskritam. We see in the East, you know, vakara is talked about as bakara. So instead of vishwam, they'll say bishwam. It's okay. Ralayor abheda, vabayor abheda. Here, instead of bakara, vakara has been mentioned. So durbala. Nana roga vibhuta nistejaso bhavanti. Nirvirya purushaha brusham paribhuyate cha strivihi. So that kind of a man is useless for a stri even. So the person may be wandering around, but this stri does not give him any value. Tathapi kamandha ayam punarapi rimramsaya. So riramsaya tameva anudhavati. Still the man does not give up. He keeps on following a woman. Satu tam trunaya apinam manyate. Worthless, even useless compared to a grass. Madirekshanaha kaminyaha panditam api vivekinam api jhiram api purusham kshanena swakataksha vishikaihi soshatam nayanti. So the glance of a woman is sufficient to, you know, make the purusha mohita. Kama mohita purusha prajna vihinaha karyakara viveka vikalaha shreyo marga chyavate. And the person falls from the dharmika marga leading to moksha. Sarvata strishu sango dharmadi sakala purushartha nasha nidanam eva yasya tu janmantariya sukrita paripaka vashad viveka udeti. However, if there is viveka due to punya earned in many janmas, saha samayak shanika sukhalava karani bhuta stryadi vishe vimukha kanta kataksha vishikha vishikha anala. So vishikha anala dagdham atmanam guru krupa kataksha amruta rasena apyayati. Guru anugraha balat kramena utpanna atmatattva sakshatkaro nitya niratishaya akhanda atmanandam anubhavati. And this person who after vairagya, not just in thought but also in acharana, not within but without, outside also, both ways, not only outside but within as well, who has vairagya, that kind of a viveka driven vairagya will make a person have shamadamadhi, shatka sampatti, thereby he'll become a real mumukshu. And becoming a real moktumichhu, due to the punya vasha, what will happen? Through the guru anugraha, krameena, over time, he'll have atma tattva sakshatkara. So he'll have atma tattva sakshatkara will be born. So utpanna atma tattva sakshatkara, this person will become that, bauri. Nitya nirtishe akhandam, akhanda atmanandam anubhavati. And this sakshatkara is niratishaya ananda swarupa duranta samsara dukkhat nirmuktascha bhavati. And there is no samsara dukkha, which is the twofold result called as moksha. So before we go into the putra sanga, putra sangaja, earlier it was three sangaja, now putra sanga. Putra is also done ninda of, and this will also be distasteful. But we have to look at the perspective of the sadhaka who has no family because he has no body. He is the one without body. He wants to hold on to that atma which is bereft of body. So the putra does not matter there at all. And for that to happen, he has to start from outside. He has to start dropping and then finally dissociate from the body. One cannot dissociate from the body and say, I have no connection with this body, but I love my child. One may do the duty, but then I love my child beyond a certain point, it will lead to shoka. There is absolutely no doubt about it. Every attachment is a seed for shoka. So the Kashi Khande, in the 40th Adhyaya, this is mentioned here. I'll just go through it for completion. Kapala kohare jivha pravishta viparitaga bror antargata drishtir mudra bhavati khechari na pidyate sarogena na cha lipyeta karmana badhyatena cha kalena yo mudram vetti khecharim chittam charati kheyasma jivha charati kheyagata tena isha khechari nama mudra siddher nishevita yavad bindu stiro dehe tavan mrityubhayam kutaha yavad baddha cha sa mudra tavad bindurna gachyati. So bindu kshaya has been done in the off here. So sarvanartha nidanam, so khechari has been advised. In orthodoxy this is there. There was one Swamiji called, he was himself called as Khechari Swamiji, very old person I had met in Swarnavalli Matha. So he was the one who taught Khechari Mudra to quite a few Mathadipatis. I'll not name the Mathas, but you know the Mathas. So many of the Mathas in the south, he had already, he was the one who taught Khechari Mudra, which is recommended in the Shastras, and to Pithadis also it is recommended, so that it leads to Samadhi. It also leads to Samadhi. In fact, Hatha Yoga, Samadhi practice, lot of Mudras are done. Khechari is one of the Mudras. If one has mastered it, then just by Khechari Mudra, one can go to Samadhi. Even this Khechari Swamiji used to go to Samadhi in that manner. But then he was so old that people were worried, and then they asked him not to do it. They requested him not to do it. So Kapala Kuhare, we know this Kapala, we know Kuhara, there is a cave in the Kapala within. So that's where the Jiva has to reach, Pravishta. And Bhror Antargata, it is between the eyes. Where is Kapala Kuhara? It is between the eyebrows, behind the eyebrows. So you can imagine the tongue to reach there, what is needed. So a lot of people do that, elongating the tongue, cutting the, you know, all that is done, but then that is not, that will not give khechari. That is physical khechari. Real khechari is that it becomes automatic. Even how long should, people ask, how long should a asana or a mudra be practiced, pranayama to be done? So Gurudev Shivananda Maharaj has said it in one of his books. He says, how long should you practice bhastrika, for example, kapalabhati, whatever people do. So this pranayama has to be done till it becomes automatic. How long do you practice walking on the ground? It takes 2-3 years for a child to walk properly, otherwise the child falls down on the ground. How long does it do? You cannot say these many years, it's an approximation. As long as the child effortlessly walks, do you think before walking? You just get up and walk. You don't think that I have to put my right leg ahead, then I have to put my left leg ahead. The child has to be taught, and then it becomes automatic. Similarly, each and every mudra, asana, pranayama, all these have to be done for one to go from Hatha Yoga to that Shaktipat kind of mode till it becomes automatic. So the Khechari Mudra can also become automatic. Pranayama can become automatic. Everything has to become automatic. That is the real Siddhi. It seems very mystical, but then Vedanta is also mystical. In fact, there are people who say yoga is mystical. Vedanta is not mystical. What is mystical? Mysticism is that which is not understood. Science is mysticism. For an illiterate, science is mysticism. Similarly, for an illiterate in yoga, yoga is mysticism. For an illiterate in Vedanta, Vedanta is mysticism. Mysticism is that which is not understood. You have to use the right means to understand. You cannot apply science and understand yoga. You cannot apply science and understand Vedanta. People do that. Physics and Vedanta is closed. Poles apart. Physics does not have consciousness at all. Consciousness is a resultant, if at all. In Vedanta, consciousness is a real nature. How can they be same? They are not same. It is armchair philosophy. You can have a sip of coffee and talk about this, blog it, have, you know, video sessions, but it is not Vedanta. Puja Swamiji would call it as Devanta. Any of this which is not Vedanta is Neo Vedanta, or, you know, you would say they consider this as Vedanta, it isn't. Yoga also misunderstood or not understood is mysticism. But you have to use the yoga shastra to understand yoga shastra. You cannot say that I'll read the books on medicine and become a doctor. Similarly, you cannot say that I'll, you know, study yogic books and apply science and then become a yogi. True with each and every field, there is nothing special about it. Somehow people think that I have a PhD in any field, I can understand, I'm brilliant. But it does not work that way. Sampradaya is necessary. So in Vedanta Sampradaya also, people who have not studied yoga, they have no qualification to talk about yoga shastra. Yoga shastra has to be learned from a yogi, not from Vedantins. Vedantins who have studied yoga have a right to talk about yogis, otherwise it is equivalent to a scientist talking about Vedanta. So we need not think otherwise. To insult yogis or Vedantins or science, we should belong to that field. Otherwise, we are not qualified to make that statement. It has no weightage. I am saying this specifically because we have seen a lot of ninda across, whether it is between Vedanta yoga, yogis calling Vedantins, you know, as its mere bookish knowledge, all that ninda we should set aside because they are not qualified. So, kapala kuhare jivha pravishta viparitaga bror antargata drishtir mudra bhavati khechari. That is called as khechari mudra. Na pidyate sa rogena, we see this. So, there is no roga ityadi. So, this is the arthavada. And it is also real in the end. In the end, the khechari, because it gives amruta, in the end it is true, but till then it is all arthavada. And since chitta is in akasha, khechari is khe. Khe is there. Khe is akasha. And char dhatu is there. So khe charati iti khe chari. So the mind is completely in akasha, resolved in akasha, so to say. Therefore, samadhi is very easy there. Very subtle level, the mind resolves, and therefore, chittam charati khe yasma, jivha charati khe gata, therefore, tena isha khechari nama. That's why it is called as khechari mudra, siddhai, by those who have siddhis. For others, it is just a name. And therefore, the khechari mudra is talked about in shastras. So, putra sangaja dukkha varananam. How can there be dukkha due to putra, putra sangha? That is given here for vairagya. Yatha bharya tatha putro api dukkha hetuhu. Just like the wife, the son is also the dukkha hetu. And just like I said that the wife or the stri being talked about, husband and man is also indicated. You have to take the flip side also. Here also putra includes putri. Just give me a moment, please. Yeah, another thing, I think Swami Paramarthananji has skipped this section, okay? So that's the reason although I'm not going to details, I still want to talk about these things. Swami Paramarthananji has covered Vichara Sagara, and I understand that he skipped this section. Because again, Pooja Swamiji used to say that don't focus on these, stay in jnana. But for those who cannot stay in jnana, we have to deal with that aspect also. So my effort is there. Yatha bharya tatha putra api dukkha hetuhu. Utpanna putrasya. Tad abhav prayukta dukkham ekameva. So anutpanna putrasya tad abhav prayukta dukkham ekameva. So those who do not have child, do not have children, they have one type of dukkha. Oh, I did not have a child. Which is the case today. We have a lot of even abortions taking place due to, it has become quite common naturally because so much of adulterated food, adulterated everything. So much of artificial produce consumed in various ways, whether as ointments or, you know, as toothpaste or God knows what. You know, food, smoking, drinking, all this. I mean, the entire culture has become a rot. And therefore, even the best, I have seen the simplest of a woman having a miscarriage. She did nothing. But then, this is how things have become. Of course, prarabdha is there, but we are looking at the laukika aspect. So what is their dukkha if there cannot be another child? And we see, one can adopt a child. Adopting a child is not tantu vistara, it is not santana. You can bring up the child in the tradition. You can get some support. All that is fine. Emotional support is there. All that is fine. One may treat the child as one's own, but still, and with Vaidika, one can adopt and have that child can have karmadhikara also. Shraddha karmadhikara ityadi. However, it is not tantu vistare. One cannot pervade hand and have gaunatma bhava in that child. That is superficial. That is artificial. There is no real atma connection there the way there is. In that janma, it isn't there. It may have been there in the earlier janma because of which the one adopted that particular child and not someone else. But then it is not as complete as having a santana. So there will be dukkha. So anutpanna putrasya tadabhava prayukta dukkham ekameva. There is only one single dukkha. I did not have a child. But one who has a child, what about that person? Has limited sukha. Like earlier we have seen, kurupi bharya will bring a particular type of dukkha. Who has a bitter tongue. One who has a sweet tongue and is beautiful, she'll bring more dukkha. This is the vairagya prakara. Similarly here, putra who is unborn will bring only one type of dukkha. I don't have a child. But one who is born, what kind of dukkha can it lead to? More dukkha. This is how vairagya is. Okay. Now this is not literal. You have to see arthavada here. So utpanna putrasya dukkham tu nana prakaram. How so? Oh, you ask a mother, she is happy with the child. What do you know? So this is the how our mind will react. What do I know who doesn't have a child? Who doesn't have a bharya? But you look at in inquiry in your own mind and see as to what the sadhu says. Tatha hi striyo garbhadharana bhave dampatyo rahoratram tadeka chintaya dukkham. So there is one chinta, oh, the child is not born. For both the parents, daiva vashad garbhadharane sati vinaduritam prasavishayini chinta. Then the old setup, even in the new one, there is risk in childbirth. During that, everyone who has to take care of the mother. And then there is fear, you know, what happens during childbirth. So jayamanasya apatyasya sritva putratva visheni chinta, whether it's going to be a boy or a girl, whoever it is, but then there is still thinking. The mother prefers a boy, let's say, and the father prefers a daughter. Still, you know, they may want both, but then who's the elder? Who should be born first? All these will lead to chinta. One may say, I'm happy with either, but then still, there may be choice. May or may not be a choice, but still, you know, one wants to know whether it's after being born, whether it's a boy or a girl. So, garbha vichheda heto, anantyad, asampurneshu maseshu, stravadi dosham vina, dashame masi, sukaprasuti vishayini chinta. I'll just read through this. And just give us bhavartha. Prasuti samaye matur jivita vishayini chinta. Jatasi shishur vina balarishtadikam jivana vishayini chinta. Jatasi shishur navanam api. Grahanam anukulasya loke durlhava taratva dritranam grahanam vishamagatim shrutva dampatyor ahoratram chinta. Jatasya shishuhu stanyam chinna pivati. Tada ashru vrishtireva dampatyor bhavati. So regarding the childbirth, whether the gender of the child, when, you know, whether it's going to be born in the 7th month, 8th month, 8th month, 9th month, 10th month, all this is going to create a bother. This is pre-birth. And then whether the child consumes the mother's milk or not, there also there is trouble. Then astrology, Jyotisha says that this child is born at this particular time, all that chinta will be there. Some graha is troubling, it will trouble in this manner. And it will stay, lifelong it may be there. Idruk chintaya sahaeva katipaya maseshu gateshu dantotpatti dashayam keshanchit shishunam balarishtavashan maranam shrutva mata pitrubhyam vyasanam anubhuyate. And there is the minds of the parents are reflected, even when the child has, you know, then the teeth come out. So that time also, lot of pain. Dantotpatti dashayam. Vyadhyadina krishi bhute shishu chatushpateshu pida nivruttyartham baliharanam kuruvanti. And now, if there is some trouble with the child and someone gives you a solution, doesn't work. Medical solution does not work. You try this, you try that. Then somebody gives some locket, something else. You go to this temple, then not even a temple, go to this, you know, go to this tantrika. So parents do anything and everything as well for the child. It may not be dharmika process at all, but still they will do it because the child, they are already attached to the child. There is gaunatma bhava. Then what will happen? They may not follow dharma. So that is shown here because the focus is dharma either. Tatsaukhyartham chandalo va pulkaso va antyajo va mlecho va atyantapashado va bhavatu yaha kashchana mantriko bhishagva tena mantrayanti bhishajayanti cha tadartham adhira bhutva mlechadyadharita devata api pranamanti. So there are some devatas, some tuchha devatas, they may take sharana. Oh, something has happened. So all types of solutions are tried. Asambhashyena sa putratvatsalyena sneham kuruvanti. Bhairavadyaneka devatodeshena swaprarthana siddhyartham smashana bhumo balin nikshipanti. So somebody says you give this bali to this Bhairava, all your problems will be solved. So the person may do it because of vatsalya towards the child. Swasya grihe devata api devalakena dhakkam nadayitva sanjali putam pujayanti. They may get somebody else who, you know, does not have the, does not know anything. But they may ask, you know, they say that, okay, you get this, you know, there are so many, you know, these solutions which are very, you know, superstitious solutions. You do this, you do that. Somebody says it, you do it. And you get this kind of person, you know, he or she should be present in a puja or something. They bring that kind of person also. Then Kshudra Raksha Bandhana Yantra Ghutikadin Shishokkanthe Dharayanti. Use some locket or something given by someone outside the religion also. Somebody talks about. One follows it. Parmeshwarat Narayanadva Parandayivam Swapneyapi Asmarantopi Putrajyartham Kulatastri Iva Tatra Tatra Nana Devata Bhajante. So put in a very very coarse and raw and very you know, blunt way. Like a adharmika woman, one follows anybody says that this is a devata, one follows. Not a devata at all. So giving up Parameshwara and Narayana, some param daivam, some daiva. Somebody says, we don't even think about such a thing in a dream, but still, for the sake of the child, one may, you know, do that kind of a, you know, deity's puja. May not be a deity also. Outside the, so Veda Bahya also. Masurikadi darshane mata pitrade sarve vrutha manakleshento mangala snanadikam varjayanti. So Dharma Shastra says that you look at a particular type of person, a dead body for example. Go to smashana, then you have to take a bath along with the clothes that you are wearing. In some cases, you may need to change your Ajnopavita also. People don't follow that. When they start following all adharmika process, they lose their marga. Masurika shantyartham tad devata vahana bhutam gardhavam aradayanti devata buddhya. I think there is Shitila Devi or Shitila Devi or something. So she is said to be the goddess of disease, for to counter diseases. So she can give only that. Counter diseases. So, but her vahana is gardhava. So this may be indicated here. So in fact, in the earlier, if you know the earlier generation, when they had, you know, the smallpox, that time they used to call it as Devi. There was no medication for it. And it was a pandemic. People used to die with smallpox. Of course, the disease isn't there anymore. There is chickenpox, but there is no smallpox. But then that time, they would do any kind of thing to get out of the situation. Similarly, now also, someone says that for your child, you do this. You do the Vahana Puja. So Vahana Puja, the Vahana happens to be donkey. So you worship the donkey also. So this is said as a, as what a person can go to, what an extent a person can go to for the child. इत्थं महता प्रयासेन शिशुरक संरक्षणं कुर्वन्तो माता पितरो शिशोः यौवन पर्यन्तं दुरन्तां चिन्तां वहतः. सो देयर इज चिंता टिल द चाइल्ड ग्रोज अप. शिशवे अत्यंतं क्रीडासक्तान बालांस ततः प्रतिनिवर्त्य विद्यायां प्रवर्तने प्रतिदिनं महद्दुःखं जायते पित्रोः. एंड ईच पेरेंट नोज, यू नो, एंड मोस्ट ऑफ द पेरेंट्स नो दैट देयर चिल्ड्रन आर प्लेफुल, दे हैव टू बी ब्रॉट टू स्टडी. And, you know, you see that my child does not listen every, you know, keeps on playing. But then the mother runs around and then drags the child and makes him study, him or her. Generally, boys. So, Patasha, Patashalayam Balantarihi Kalahayamanaha स्वयं अन्यान् ताडयन्तो अन्यैः ताड्यमानाश्च पुत्राः पित्रो दुःखहेतवो भवन्ति. एंड देन व्हेन द चिल्ड्रन आर फाइटिंग, दे आर वेदर अ चाइल्ड इज हर्ट और ही हैज हर्टेड अदर्स, दुःखहेतु अगेन. प्राचीन संस्कारवशात् विद्याग्रहणा पाठवे ग्रहणपाठवे सत्यपि प्रवचनपटुता भावे प्रवचनपटुतायामपि पुत्राणां द्यूतादि दुर्व्यापारासक्ताव असह्यम दुखम पित्रो हो. सो जनरली इन द इनिशियल इयर्स दुखा फॉर द मदर, देन लेटर इयर्स दुखा फॉर द फादर. डज नॉट अंडरस्टैंड थिंग्स विच हैव बीन सेड, और इवन इफ यू अंडरस्टैंड, नॉट एबल टू कन्वे. सो बेसिकली करियर ओरिएंटेड इश्यूज. ततः यौवनातिक्रमाद अर्वागेव पुत्राणां विवाह संपत्ति विषय चिंता. देन विवाह एंड संपत्ति ऑफ द चिल्ड्रन, देयर इज दुख. एनी कर्म इज दुख रियली. सो हियर द एफर्ट दैट वन हैज टू टेक, आई मीन वन पेरेंट्स मे डू इट लविंगली, बट दैट्स द अटैचमेंट. स्टिल दैट इज ट्रेनिंग द बॉडी माइंड सेंस कॉम्प्लेक्स. It is definitely straining. One may say, I lovingly do it, but then lovingly you take care of the child. The child does not change, there is going to be dukkha. No matter what kind of parent, there will be dukkha, sleepless nights. That is the dukkha being talked about. It is not about putra being, not to have putra. But it is shown that one has to, it's a balanced thing. There's a balance. So it's always, there will be sukha, but the sukha is not due to the putra. The sukha is due to one's own sukha projected there. Atmanastu kamaya sarvam priyam bhavati. That is a Brihad mantra. Kulashila adi sampanna vadhu prapti vishayini mahati chinta. Marriage of the child. Oh, whether he'll get a good bride, whether she'll get a good groom. Endless, you know, एंडलेस दुख. पुत्रादि विवाहार्थं धनाद्य अर्जने महान क्लेश. नीड इनफ मनी फॉर मैरिज, एस्पेशली इंडियन मैरिज. इत्थं यौवनावधि माता पित्रोः पुत्र विषयिणी अनवधिका चिंता. दैवज्ञ मुखात् पुत्रस्य अल्पायुष्त्वं श्रुत्वा अपमृत्यु परिहाराय अनेक उपाय अनेक उपायान आचरन्ति. भाग्यमान्द्याद्यदि सुतो म्रियते तदा माता पितरौ उरसि शिरसि च ताडयन्तौ यावज्यं हृदितः. सो पुत्र शोक इफ इट इज देयर, इफ देयर इज सम, नो, आयुष्य हैज सम इश्यू विद द फॉर द चाइल्ड, देन देयर इज दुःख. They do a lot of things for Mrti Parihara. And even after that, if the child dies, then Putra Shoka. Entire life there is Putra Shoka. Balarishtadibhya Uttirana Putro Yada Krutadaro Bhavati Tada Dushikshitaha Putraha Swadara Patyadin Eva Atyadarena Oshayati Natu Mahata Kleshana Saurakshitavanto Pitaro. And we have seen this nuclear families. Married has, see, look at it both ways. Son who has married, who will he listen to? He has a new family. Especially after the child is born. After the child is born, the person is connected more with the child than with the parents. Because that person is himself a parent. So there is more connection towards the wife and the child than with the parents. This is natural to everyone. But still, in a setup where everyone stays together, everyone works together, everyone takes care of each other, it's a different culture earlier. Now with the, you know, houses are really small, there's nothing more in the village, so one has to move out. And the setup has been made to attack the culture. That being so, and Kali Yuga, so it is earned. That is the prarabdha earned by Indians and especially by, you know, those who have given up dharma. Then what will happen? They are focused, people are focused more towards the spouse than the parents who have brought up the child. This child is a grown up now, whether it's a man or a woman. The woman leaves the parents' house. Leaves the parents' house and then she can't take care of multiple parents. Distance also is an issue. Therefore, there was value for a son as well as a daughter. If a person has to have children, one should have as many children. Dharma Shastra does not say one child, two children. All this is modern thing. Those who follow it may follow it for a different reason. But as many children that you can afford, you have to beget. Afford to take care of. That is why, you know, the earlier Ashirvada, today if someone gives, I think the woman would, you know, slap the person, right? Figuratively. But Ashtaputra Saubhagyavati Bhava, today it is, one will be shocked. Ashtaputra, the blessing was have 8 children. May you have 8 children. That's why you see old families, there were, you know, 4, 8, 10 children. Some Americans still do have. They follow that. Americans follow that. Forget Indians. Nonetheless, the reason is because a daughter is as important as a son. The son has karmadhikara. Daughter does not have karmadhikara. Oh, why there is no karmadhikara? People may shout. It is not there. You cannot have ardha jaratinya. Vaidika sampradaya says, Vedas tell you, you are a jiva, you will have moksha. If you follow this. I want moksha, but I throw everything aside. Then why do you want moksha? How will you get moksha? Therefore, one should not claim karmadhikara if it is not there. Follow varnashrama dharma for karmadhikara. But a daughter is important. Without the son being there, karmadhikara not being there to the child, there won't be shraddhadi karma. And therefore, there may be no gati for the pitru. But same is true, they say that there is no mukti without a putra. There is no mukti without a putri also. Because equally important is kanyadana. People who know only half and then they start shouting, they get nothing. So you have to understand dharma completely. Not just hear something from some leftists or some idiots and then they want you to do that. They want you to object to your own people. They want you to drop off the culture. So instead of that, understand the conspiracy behind, whether it call it as a conspiracy theory also, you understand it and then learn from the right sources. Putra is as, the reason I am saying is that because I had an aunt who had 3 daughters. A little distant aunt. But I heard later that she had 3 daughters, well, all well-to-do, but she heard after her husband passed away, there was some, I think, Garuda Purana or something was read. And then she heard that without a son, there is no moksha. She lost her mind. That's it. She lost her mind. Then when someone told me, I said that this is all bogus. It is only halfway. Without the putri also, there is no moksha. It is said so that you beget more and more children. So that they can follow dharma. You teach them dharma. That is the reason it is said. It is not that without the putra, there is no moksha. And with the putra, without the putri, there is moksha. Moksha is not that kind of a moksha, that jnanena moksha that we talk about. They talk about gati. That is called as moksha. They think that, you know, the one will become a preta. It's not true. Without the putri also, there is the same problem. Without the putri, one does not get kanyadana. And there is no bigger dana than kanyadana. Of course, vidyadana, all that is talked about. But then kanyadana for a parent is a big thing. So how will it happen without a putri? So had she known that, maybe she would have not lost her mind. In that shoka, she passed away later. Nonetheless, so all this has to be understood. And there is vairagya for a person who does not want any of this. Anyway, I'll just finish this para. I already shot the time over. But anyway, so... Just like a woman leaves her parents, a man also leaves his parents. So they are more interested in their nuclear family than in its entirety. So bharya tad bandhu jivan janadhinah pitaro adikshipati cha marma bhedi bhihi ninda vachanaihi. And then they start insulting their parents. Of course, there's an insult we have seen earlier also. Old people get more insulted because of a lot of reasons. You know, the patience is also lost in the young. And the old need a lot of patience. So they get more insulted. And now there is additional insult because additional occasions for insult. Unfortunate, but then that's the fact of life. Which can lead to vairagya. Dushkruta phalabhuto asat putra pitro parjitam. Prabhutandharam sarvopakaranani cha baladadaya pitarau sharira matrao sheshitau. Pitarau is mata pitaru. Is a eka shesha. So mata pitaru, parents. Sharira matra avasheshitau. Sharira matra avasheshitau. The dhana is taken by the putra. Very little is left for the parents to take care of themselves. Grihe avasthapya swadharapatyabhi saha anyatra gatva sukham vasati. And then the person leaves the parents. Mahata kleshena samvardhita vatoho pitroho annapane apina kalpayati. Does not think about the parents. Even, you know, what they would be eating, etc. Pratyuta pitroho upakuruvantam dayalum shapatyapi. Ittham papinam putram prapya pitaro dirgham nishvasita ittham putravata anubhuyamanam mahat dukham na aputrasyasti. So in comparison, one may in the end, you know, regret. One might, you know, because the dukkha in that old age, one may forget the sukha that the putra has given so far. One starts focusing only on the dukkha. And then in that old age, when the mind is not so functional, when the body is not functional, one may regret and say, it was better not to have children than have these kind of children. That is where the sadhu is coming from. Therefore, he says, aputrasya na bhavati mad dukkham. One who has putra may have to face all this. And most of them, even the, you know, the best of the people that we know, they have, you know, for whatever reason, we are not saying they're right or wrong. But then, if you look at the condition of the parents, that is how it will be. Evam sarva dukkha nidanam jaya putradikam nyatva vivekino dhareshanayaha putreshanayascha vittishtanti. So, now this has a background in Brihadaranyaka Upanishad, where eshanatraya is talked about. The desire for all three. Putreshana, Vitteshana, Lokeshana. Vairagya towards all is needed. Mahatas Sukrutasya Phalabhuta Pitarau Devata Buddhya Samaradhayan Sat Putrastu Durlabataraha. However, a putra who treats the parents as, you know, matrudevo bhava, pitrudevo bhava, a person who is matrudeva and pitrudeva is very durlava, durlava tara, very difficult to get that kind of putra. So in general, if you one thinks, then there's more probability that children will be of this type. This is what is said for vairagya utpatti, mind you. Then we'll look at dhanasanga dukkhaja, the dhanasangaja dukkham. Dukkha born out of dhana. This is known, most of us know it, but then we'll go through this in the next part. Huh? Sorry for a long class and talk on a tangent, but I think it was needed because this topic is dealt with orthodoxy, and out of the outside orthodoxy, this is not talked about, and it deserves an attention. That is the reason it exists in the Vichara Sagara. That is the reason I wanted to spend time on, although the details I didn't want to go into, but I wanted to talk about broadly why it has that importance. Hopefully it will be useful nonetheless. Om Tat Sat. सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धेर्दृक्यत्व निर्मलं पारं सर्ववेदान्त वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम तदेव नमस्कृत इति मे निश्चितामतिः. नमस्ते.
हरि ओम.